like in the last, my direct words, it was, Scott talked about the opportunity to serve businesses that might.
Definitely. We're behind our coach. And it makes perfect sense. With a game like this, and a loss like this, you definitely have to hit the reset button. You got to be able to pull everybody together so that we're able to go through the rest of this conference play, which we got a whole lot more games. We just got another game added on, you know, in place of the Akron game that we missed. So we got a lot of football left. Only played 3 games. I'm still excited for this season. It's a hard loss, definitely. You know, this is a team that you really want to stack yourself up against. Michigan, great team, great atmosphere. But we're going to take this one, and we're going to learn from it, definitely. We're going to learn from it, and we're going to push forward. I don't know exactly what else to say. I would guess that's what you would, you know, expect me to say, because it's the truth. I feel like everybody wants to say things, but it's when you actually do them. So we're going to get out on the field on Monday, and we're going to do what we need to do.
Hey, Luke, you guys were good against the run in the first 2 games. What changed from your guys' end in this game, and what do they do well running the ball?
Well, first, we had missed tackles there in the first couple of drives that killed us. I thought we matched them pretty well physically. I didn't feel like, I don't know how the D-line feels, but I didn't think we were just getting moved all over the place by any means. And obviously, you just got to watch film and see for sure, but they didn't feel like they were getting moved all over. They did good things. You can't take anything away from them. You know, they're big physical dudes. They got a video line, good blocking tight ends, and then their backs run the ball really well. But I think just the missed tackles, you know, you start off like that, it's tough. You can't do that. You can't do that right off the bat.
Were they doing some misdirection stuff that got you guys going this way and then having to come back?
Yeah, you know, that's what they do, you know, the pro-style offense like that. You got some smoke and mirrors and things going different directions, mess with your eyes, and they're really good at it, you know, that's what they do. So they definitely did a good job of executing their stuff.
Jared on the other side, just the ability to run the ball and had some protection problems. Was it something that Michigan's front 7 was doing, or I guess how would you attribute to those struggles?
I guess I attribute that to our start, you know. Not to not answer your question, but to get out what I'm really thinking about is we've had this kind of start to the last 3 games of us not being able to convert, you know, on the touchdown, because we were driving the ball really well at the start. We get the pick, and then when you get down on a team like this, it's really hard to be able to come at it, and they take advantage of it, and they definitely did. Started bringing pressures, doing a lot of, you know, unique things that we would expect if we weren't, you know, in a closer game at the start like we wanted to be. And with uniqueness comes, you know, a whole lot more need of communication, a whole lot more need of figuring out exactly what, you know, what's coming, what's not coming. Because like Luke said, with the offense, they have smoke and mirrors. The same thing goes with defense. They walk up a couple guys, push them back in the coverage, and bring somebody else from the edge, blitzing or something like that. So they did mostly what we expected. But if we would have been able to come out and have the start that we were really hoping for, I feel like this game would have been a whole lot different.
The coach said that he thought that this was going to be rock bottom. Do you guys believe that as well?
Thought that this was going to be rock bottom?
This game that this is bottom, yeah.
This is going to be, we're not going to go any lower than this. We talked about that this is the bottom. If you're in a swimming pool, this is the bottom of the pool. You finally touch your feet on the ground, and when you're at that point, you're able to push off, you know. It's not about swimming, it's about actually being able to get back to the top. So we're going to use that, we're going to run with that. There is a lot that we're going to have to do. It's going to be hard, which I'm fine with. Whatever we have to do to be able to be a good football team and be able to compete with good football teams like Michigan. Hats off to them for, you know, sticking with their game plan and playing the game.
What makes you believe that it won't be worse?
Because we have a coaching staff and players that aren't going to allow it. That's it. you know, look me in the eyes, and I hope you can see that I'm not going to let it get any worse than this.
Hey, Joe, we get talked about a lot, just generally about football, but can you put into words how hard it is to operate when you're behind the sticks as often as you guys find yourself?
Yeah. Like I said, when you're behind the points, you know, when the other team's able to get up a quick 14, 17, 21 like they did for us this game, you get a whole lot more uniqueness. You get a whole lot of the blitzes that come, you know, they bring in the different kind of packages that come when they're feeling like they can put, you know, put you away kind of thing. So that's a whole lot harder than when you're playing a good game. And they're worried about, you know, you doing this, you doing that. It gives them the spot to be in the driver's seat of you now worrying about what they're going to be bringing you. So that's probably the hardest part about being, you know, behind. You know, you just there's a whole lot of stuff that comes, a whole lot of uniqueness that gets played into the game.
One more for these guys. Yeah. Scott said on Thursday it was rough practice and a lot of mistakes that were made in that walkthrough kind of translated today in the game. As captains, what do you guys have to do to make sure there's a better attention to detail and preparation throughout the week to prevent something like this happening?
Yeah, no doubt. No, I mean, we just got to set the example. We got to keep doing whatever we can. And it's not easy, you know, it's tough. But I'm pretty confident in the leaders that we have. The leadership that we have and the coaching staff that we have, that we're gonna get it down. And, you know, we expect that this week. That's what we expect from this team. And just because this outcome doesn't mean we expect anything different on Monday. Honestly, it should be at a whole new level. You know, like Coach Frost mentioned in the locker room, we're gonna find out who loves football. You know, and that's what you want. You know, if this is tough, you know, this is a tough situation to be in, and a lot of guys have been in this situation in the last few years. But it's going to be how we respond, and us four captains, I know what direction we're going, so I know what direction our guys are going to follow us.